Sunday broadcast of the NBA. The man who puts the dynamite in this lineup, Andre Iguodala and the Philadelphia 76ers go up against the Milwaukee Bucks and their big block, Andrew Bogut. 76ers, Bucks, NBA action.
Glad you could join us on this Sunday afternoon. 2K Sports presents the NBA. You can feel the energy here in the Bradley Center. The Bucks looking to please their fans in this Eastern Conference matchup. Look at the 76ers starting group. Evan Turner and Iguodala on the perimeter. Elton Brand is out there with Spencer Hawes and Iverson. And for Milwaukee, Ilyasova and Bogut, they're inside. Jennings and Salmons in the backcourt. And Maggette. You know, Clark, I think last year's Bucks showed just how much of a difference that a point guard can truly make with the team.
Boy, did they ever. I mean, Brandon Jennings. Sometimes that's all it takes for a team to click is a point guard like Jennings. Quick, mercurial, exciting, explosive, confident. I mean, I think he answered some questions about his overseas adventure in the meantime between his first year and leaving high school.
Let's go to our great sideline reporter, Doris Burke, for an update. Doris?
Kevin, a big reason the Milwaukee Bucks finally made up some ground was the work of head coach Scott Skiles. He demands accountability and hard work from his players, and last year he got it. Midseason acquisition John Salmon said, "Since I've been here, you can definitely tell the coaches have the players' attention. I think the coaching staff sets the tone for our focus. I think it should be exactly like that." Guys, back to you.
All right, thank you, Doris. Here is Jennings after the made shot from Allen Iverson. Fades back. Jennings with the bucket. Here's Iverson. Iverson right side. Now Hawks. Five on the clock. With 1 second left, Allen Iverson again. Iverson's got his second bucket.
He makes such intelligent plays with the basketball. Always aware, always a threat to score.
Jennings kicks to Ilyasova. No good. And the 76ers go the other way. If you fail once, try again. That's what Ilyasova did. He didn't make a big impact in his first go-around. And Parker went to Europe for a few seasons, came back to the Bucks ready to contribute, and he did.
Yes, he did. He's able to make threes. And when you can do that at his position, he's kind of that new stretch four position player, if you will. Big guy that can get out there and knock down perimeter shots to help spread the floor. He's got to get a little stronger so he can do a good, better job rebounding. He's actually a pretty high-energy rebounder right now, and he plays with great effort. So I think as he gets stronger, he'll just enhance the kinds of things that he's able to do even now.
Bogut releases, and he hits that one from down low. Bogut's got his first points in this one. And here are the 76ers now. All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
A bit ago, Doug Collins and I were able to chat. The opportunity to put up big numbers offensively is there for them, he believes, if they can just stick to what they've been working on. He said, "I think we've established what works for us and what doesn't. Now it's just a matter of execution. Let's see what that is exactly, guys."
Doris, thank you. And Clark, it sounds like the early focal point here is on that offense.
Well, you have to take what the defense gives you, and then you have to be consistent. Maintain some consistency. I think those are always keys.
Now the 76ers with it. Here's Iverson, and the layup is good. Iverson's got 6 points.
I love his tenacity and aggressiveness on offense. He's lightning quick and loves to take it to the rim.
Iverson against Jennings. Here's Bogut, and no good. But close on that one, so he'll shoot two.
Bogut's low post game is really starting to round into form. I mean, the Bucks did a really good job of getting him touches and getting him involved offensively last year.
The first free throw is good. And Mbamute's checked in for Milwaukee. Red comes in for John Salmons. Then for the 76ers, Lou Williams is checked in for Hawes. And it's Holiday in for Allen Iverson. And he can't hit the second. Clark, one area, though, where Bogut has room to grow, getting to the free throw line and knocking him down.
Yeah, just over two free throws made per game on only around 63% shooting. That's not good enough.
Brand, good.
Great vision on display there. The pass led him perfectly to the basket. That's how you do it.
Well, there's no doubt the Sixers, Clark, one of the most disappointing teams last season in the NBA.
Yeah, only 27 games won, down from 41 won the year before, Kevin. That's a huge decrease.
The 76ers leading by three. Outside, Williams. Jennings against Holiday. The 76ers need to get off a shot. Williams' shot is off. And Clark, did it surprise you just how bad the Sixers were last game? And he slams it home. Here's the replay on the spike slam pin.
That's just poor defense, Kevin. Somebody's got to get back and defend the basket. Instead, they give up a rack-to-rack finish.
Here's Holiday. 37 seconds left in the first. And Jennings picks him up defensively. And Holiday kicks to Brand. Iguodala left side. He's guarded by Mbamute. Four on the shot clock. Takes it up. It's blocked. And here's Maggette. Not on the scoreboard yet. Head against Brand. And he can't manage to get up a decent shot on the foul. Two free throws coming up. They get Andre Iguodala.
Second team foul. At the line for the Bucks, Michael Redd. Two shots.
Ties it up, and this next one could give them the lead. And he gives them the lead. Here's Holiday. Iverson up top. Nails the easy jumper. Iverson's got 8 points. And our first quarter of play over. Some good numbers on the board so far. 76ers on top. They lead by one.
They've dominated the glass early on, and that's always a good sign. Rebounding is an effort stat, and they've shown tremendous effort so far.
And we'll be back in just a moment. Close game here at the start of the second quarter of play. Here's Iverson. He's got eight. Taking a look at the 76ers. Maurice Spates and Spencer Hawes up front. Evan Turner and Iguodala on the perimeter. Here's Turner. Iverson outside. Mbamute with the steal.
It's hard to make a pinpoint pass from that far away. Oh! They've been trading buckets and trading leads. What outstanding competitors out there.
Here's Iverson. Mbamute is out of UCLA, taken in the second round, and boy, Clark, what a find.
Yeah, he's a terrific defender, Kevin, and when you can come into the league, come into the NBA, and defend multiple positions at a high level, you have great, great value, and that's what he does. He's quick, he's strong, he's long, he's aggressive, and he can defend players 1 through 4 effectively.
Here's Iverson. 15 road wins for the Sixers a season ago, Clark.
That's not too bad. I mean, it's not a great total, but it actually was a better number than their home record, which is hard to figure. They were a decent road team, Kevin, when you look at that number.
Here's Milwaukee now. Back to that Philly stat. It is rare in any sport, especially basketball, to have more wins on the road than at home.
I agree with you there, Kevin. I mean, it really is. It's not something that you're going to brag about because their play at home was so dismal, but nonetheless, it is kind of an interesting factoid.
Let's check out what Doris Burke has for us.
Kevin, thank you. Swingman Evan Turner out of Ohio State, the number 2 overall pick for the Sixers, the National College Player of the Year last season. asked about the pressure of being such a high pick and helping get the 76ers back to the playoffs, Turner said, "I don't have any pressure. I have a lot of demands on myself. If Philly expects me to be great, then we have a mutual understanding." That sounds like a confident young man, guys.
Boy, you gotta like that. Thanks, Doris. A different look for Milwaukee. Andrew Bogut, he's checked in for Gooden. Maggette comes in for Carlos Delfino. And it's Dueling in for Brandon Jennings. And then for Philadelphia, Brand's checked in. Knocked loose.
He got caught napping. You've got to pay attention and protect the ball.
Allen Iverson on the wing. 12 points for him. Over Dueling. Allen Iverson again. Iverson's got 14.
I'll tell you what, he's been an efficient scorer for them. He executes, takes good shots, and he always seems to make a basket when it's needed most. He's excellent at timely baskets.
Bucks really made an impact in the postseason, scaring the Hawks and taking them to a seventh game.
Yeah, that's very strong progress. They bought into their team identity, and they really played hard for each other. That was impressive. Brought back the fear of the deer phrase, which I haven't heard in a while. That's the Bucks mascot for those of you all that may not be familiar.
And that one goes in, two from the line that time. 14 wins in the conference for the 76ers last year. Not a great total.
Not at all. I mean, there's no way to say it other than that. And what's strange is they had 25 wins against the East the year before that. So just a sharp, sharp decline.
Bucks trail by three. Clark talking about their decline. It has to be in part because of some of the injuries they've had.
I think so. I mean, injuries were certainly a part of it, Kevin, but they had to deal with that in 09 as well. I think they just weren't as effective getting up and down the court. They kind of slowed their pace a bit, and that took away from what they excelled at.
And it's the 76ers with the ball after the basket by Milwaukee. And good with the shot, and the whistle blows for the contact and a chance for one more. First, and some changes here for the Bucks. Ilyasova, he's checked in for Mbamute. Red comes in for John Salmons. And it's Jennings in for Keon Dueling. And he makes the free throw. Last season was a tumultuous one for Allen Iverson.
You know, from an unhappy situation in Detroit, an aborted pairing with the Memphis Grizzlies, and then a short stay in Philly, I mean, it was musical chairs for him. And you heard things weren't much better on the home front, unfortunately.
And it's another Milwaukee shot right there going in.
His height is really an advantage on that medium-range jumper. He can just rise up and pop it right over the defenders and get a good shot every time.
Here's Iverson, 17 points in the game. Rips it down.
Allen Iverson.
Clark, with Iverson in mind, what are your thoughts on how the last few seasons have played out for him?
Turbulent, bumpy, unfortunate, but in my mind, it doesn't take away from what he represented in his prime, which was about 12 years of one of the best little men to ever play the game.
Red. And another three from Milwaukee.
Kevin, that's just not good defense. You can't be giving players of his talent level looks like that. Come on now.
Jennings against Iverson. Tosses it up. And the 76ers tack on two more.
He's on fire. Whatever the defense is throwing at him just ain't working.
Bucks trail by three. Iverson is tagged with the reach. That's his first foul. And the Bucks with some changes. Carlos Delfino's checked in for Maggette. And it's Dueling in for Brandon Jennings. Then for the 76ers, Lou Williams has checked in for Hawes. And it's Holiday in for Allen Iverson. Here's Dueling, the Bucks with the turnover.
76ers ball.
The 76ers leading by three. And here's Holiday. No points for him. Dumps it off. Here's Williams. Laces one from three.
He might not get a better look than that all game. You have to get closer to him. He's not going to bite you. Get up in him.
Timeout called, the Bucks.
And now, introducing Hip Hop the Rabbits. There you go, fans. That was your energy. One more time. Let them hear it.
Here's Dueling. They can make this a two-for-one opportunity. And almost gets it to go, so he'll shoot two here. That one on Turner.
They haven't done as much at the line here in the second.
13-5. At the line for the Bucks, Keon Dueling, taking two shots.
The first one falls.
Even though they're trailing, they're having some success from the foul line here, and that could go a long way towards getting them back into it.
He hits one, then misses the second attempt from the free throw line. The 76ers leading by five. Holiday with it. Still looking to get on the scoreboard. Here's Turner, and here's Brand. Sensational block, but they get it back with the fadeaway. The shot by Turner, no good.
Really not enough defensive pressure there to force that miss. He's got to be disappointed.
And the first half is now in the books. And we'll get it going after this from the Bradley Center.
For joining us. Now it's time for the HP Halftime Report. For the Philadelphia 76ers, they have the lead against Milwaukee. They've been in an incredible rhythm offensively. You're wondering why it's dark in the gym? They've shot the lights out. Just a ridiculous first half for Allen Iverson. He's carrying the team, doing everything he can to put them over the top. And for the Bucks, it's a grinded out effort. They're getting a ton of points from their bench players, a big injection of energy. The first half, a productive one for Michael Redd. Lighten up that scoreboard. He's making it ring like a pinball machine. Now, back to Kevin Harlan, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke. We'll get you ready for the second half.
Well, it's been a tight game as we enter the second half. Both teams going at it. The 76ers leading by five. John Salmons and Corey Maggette fill out the wings. Ilyasova and Bogut, they're inside, and Jennings. So that's who Scott Skiles starts the second half with. The Bucks made a playoff run last year, and you have to think it was because of their play here at home.
Yeah, they upped their win total at home by six last year. They won 28 games at home. That might not seem like a whole lot, but when you look at the standings from last year, they were only six games up on Toronto, so that made a difference.
So it's Milwaukee after the miss from Andre Iguodala. You know, watching the Bucks, you talk about Coach Scott Skiles and what he thinks of this young kid. He says he's a pretty quick study.
Yeah, he is. I mean, the kid's got a terrific head for the game, a thirst for knowledge, and a desire to get better.
Here's Jennings after the made shot from Allen Iverson. Here's Ilyasova, and they're unable to get the tying basket there.
This is one of the key reasons why they're losing. You have to get more production out of your core star players.
Iverson against Salmons. Great anticipation.
He got baited in the throwing that one. The defense was well on top of him.
Iverson gets the reach-in call. That's foul number two for him. Here's Jennings. Baseline jumper, kept alive, Ilyasova. finally knocks it down. 7 points in the game. Here's Iverson. They lead by one. And Jennings picks him up defensively. Here's Iguodala. Connects from in close. And the 76ers lead by three.
No way to argue with that shot. I mean, if you get it that close to the hoop, those will go up with it strong right away.
Now Jennings. Bogut backing him down. Fades back. Jennings with the bucket. Jennings has got his second basket of the game. And here comes Iverson. 23 points in the game. He's guarded by Jennings. Jennings against Iverson. From the wing, again Philadelphia.
No wasted opportunities for him. He's been as efficient as a heat pump.
Bucks trail by three. Jennings kicks to Ilyasova. Covered by Brand. Here's Bogut. And it's another Milwaukee shot right there going in. Here's Iverson. 25 points in the game. And Jennings picks him up defensively. Now Hawks. Iguodala dishes to Iverson. The steal.
The defense anticipated the kickout the whole time. Great D leads to easy offense.
Here's Iverson. 1:38 left in the third. He's guarded by Jennings. There's the double team with Bogut. Iverson passes to Brand. Back to Iverson. And Jennings picks him up defensively. Shot clock at three. And oh, that was close. He draws the foul. He'll shoot two.
Yeah, it's a no-brainer. You got to stop the layup there. Make him earn his points from the line.
At the line, 76ers. Allen Iverson. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. A different look for Milwaukee. And Bahamute comes in for Ilyasova. And it's dueling in for Brandon Jennings. Second free throw, no good.
He couldn't make them all, but at least he got this game tied up. If you want to make the leap out of the lottery like the Bucks team did a year ago, you've got to win in conference games, and that's exactly what they did.
Calgary against Iguodala. Bogut gets the bucket. Here's Iverson. He's got 26. Here's Turner. And Holiday kicks to Iverson. 5 to shoot. 3 seconds left. And the jumper is good. Iverson's got 28. And the Bucks against the East. 31 wins for them against the Eastern Conference. That was 10 up from the season before.
You know, and some people might think that maybe the East got a little weaker. I don't think that was the case at all. I think you've got to give all the credit to the Milwaukee Bucks. This is a team that overcame some injuries and adversity, had excellent coaching from Scott Skiles, and is a team headed in the right direction, I think. You should leave those long bomb passes alone.
Here's Dueling, guarded by Holiday. And here's Dueling. He has 5. And Bahamute with it. That's in there, Dueling with the assist. And the Bucks lead by 4. Some great basketball so far as we end the third quarter.
We've seen Andrew Bogut getting it done. He has 9 points and 2 blocks.
Bucks lead by 4. And now let's send it to our sideline reporter, Doris Burke, for a Sprite Spark of the game. Doris?
Hi, like, Kevin, the spark in this game, the big push we saw by the Bucks. They've been on quite a run, and this mojo they hope to continue as this game wears on.
And thank you, Doris. That run was a defining moment for sure.
Yep, that's exactly when it all came together.
Here's Jennings. And so in the game for the 76ers, Higgy and Brand are at the forward spots. Evan Turner is out there with Allen Iverson and Hawes.
The defender was overzealous that time. You can't put that much body on the ball handler when he's driving.
Here is Jennings. The three.
I'm sure coach would like to see them take more higher percentage shots. They have the lead, but they've not been able to knock down the threes as well as they did in that first half.
Here's Iverson following the bucket by the Bucks. Iverson right side. Laid in with the D draped all over him. Iverson's got 30. Bucks leading by four. Jennings with the ball. Iverson is tagged with the reach. And that'll be his third foul so far. Here's Delfino. Got a piece of it. It stays here. And some changes here for the Bucks. Andrew Bogut, he's checked in for Gooden. Maggette comes in for Carlos Delfino. And Michael Redd has subbed in for John Salmons. Here's Jennings. In low to Bogut. Just five to shoot. Behind the arc. And Brandon Jennings with the three. And the Bucks lead by seven.
Well, both teams have been rolling. The fans love this kind of game.
Here's Iverson. The shot is off. Nice D from Maggette.
He's been AWOL this quarter. When his team is down and in need of some scoring from him, he hasn't shown up.
Red's shot is right there.
When he gets it going like this, you've got to double team it. That's your only hope.
Here is Hawes. On the wing, it's Iguodala, covered by Maggette.
The defense hasn't let him get too many clean looks in this game. He's having trouble getting it done at the offensive end here, and I think you've got to credit the defense. Contact certainly altered that shot. The official was right on top of it.
At the line for the box, Corey Maggette taking two shots.
First one falls for.
They haven't been to the line as much as they were in the first half. Sure, you have the lead, but you don't want to settle for jumpers throughout and let the other team come back on you in the second half.
Drew Holiday, he's checked in for Allen Iverson. And good on the second, so he makes them both.
Corey Maggette having a good one. He has 8 points, then he's also come up with the steal, adding to their defensive effort. Passing and free throws, those are two areas where you love to get production.
Iguodala buries the short-range shot.
He's just so gifted offensively. He's a tough guy to match up with.
Jennings passes to Mbamute. Leads him with the pass. And he jams it in beautifully.
A pretty finish right there, Kevin. Take it up and then throw that thing down.
He didn't have to make it special. Just get the job done.
That's right. Keep it simple.
Now here's Iguodala. Hawes, covered by Bogut. Shot's good from Hawes. Here's Jennings. 2:25 left in the game. Here's Mbamute. Knocks it loose. Bogut backing him down. Four on the clock. Got a hand on it. The 76ers trail by nine. Now Brand. Screen by Brand. Iguodala outside. He's guarded by Jennings. Here's Turner. Rebounded by Corey Maggette.
Kevin, that's the kind of shot you want. You can't ask for better execution on offense, but sometimes they just don't fall.
Timeout called, the 76ers. They're down by 11. 1:35 left in the fourth. Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Thank you, Kevin. I got a chance to hear what Doug Collins was saying to the team. He pumped this team up saying, it's moments like these that you play for. Leave everything you have on the court and play like you know you can. Let's watch, Kevin.
Looking at who's out there now for the Bucks. Ilyasova comes in for Mbamute. And it's Selman's in for Michael Redd. The 76ers making a switch right here.
Boy, he's making it look really easy right now. I expect them to continue to run the offense through him until the defense makes some change plans.
Here is Jennings. Ilyasova backs him down. Great finish in traffic. And the Bucks lead by 10.
Your best bet is to deny him that position. Do your work early on defense. Once he gets inside on you, you've already lost the battle.
On offense here, the Bucks. Here's Maggette. Rips it down with both hands.
Kevin, over the course of the game, they've gotten it done. This should be an insurmountable lead.
Here's Iverson. 102 left in the game. Back to Iguodala. Easy shot again, Philadelphia.
When you get a hot hand like him, it's real simple. You need to keep going with it.
Jennings kicks to Ilyasova. To the paint, Salmons. And that's good on the layup.
Yeah, it's all but over now. They're doing whatever they want out there.
Timeout called, the 76ers. They're losing by 12. 35 seconds left to the fourth. Clark, what's your take?
They're going to talk strategy or perhaps what's on the dinner menu tonight. Because this one is really about over. They have no chance of winning this game.
Here is Williams. Jacks up the triple. That falls. Nice feed that time from Andre Iguodala. Williams has got his second basket. 8 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Here is Jennings. Just 5 on the clock. And another basket for Milwaukee.
They're leading by double digits. And I'd say this game is essentially done.
Here's Williams. And the 76ers tack on 2 more. Here is Jennings. And so the Bucks take the win. They pulled off this win, Clark, with respectable performances on both ends of the floor.
Yeah, I think it was just really a nice overall effort, Kevin.
Now it's time to say so long. For Clark Kellogg, Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan, along with our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. Now it's time to present our Jordan Brand Player of the Game, Brandon Jennings.